You know that frustrating feeling when a message takes more than a few seconds to send? Well, it's hard to imagine today, but before the mid-19th century, sending news across the ocean could take weeks to arrive. Then, thanks to an incredible yet mostly forgotten technological achievement, that gap was shrunk from weeks to seconds, a feat that kicked off the global age of instant communication that we take for granted today. For most of human history, the only way to send a message across a long distance was to have it delivered in person, which was limited by how fast someone could travel. The invention of the electric telegraph in the 1830s sparked a revolution. It allowed messages to be sent across wires as electrical pulses, which could be translated into letters and words. Within a decade of its invention, thousands of miles of telegraph cables were installed between major cities worldwide, linking governments, businesses, individuals, and the press. But there was still an enormous, daunting gap. How to send a signal thousands of miles across the vast Atlantic Ocean, linking Europe and the Americas? In 1854, an ambitious, wealthy young American entrepreneur named Cyrus West Field was presented with a business opportunity to connect a telegraph cable from New York City to Newfoundland, which would shorten the arrival of news by ship from abroad by a day or two. Field pushed the idea even further. What if a line could be extended all the way to Ireland and then onto London, which at the time was the hub of the global economy? Sensing that his project could change the course of history, Field was undaunted by the immense challenge. He raised money from a wide network of investors, including the British and American governments, which also provided the necessary ships for laying the cable in exchange for top priority communication rights on the future telegraph line. Field also recruited some of the top engineers and scientists of his time to develop a cable durable enough to carry a signal thousands of miles across the ocean floor. Laying out the actual cable by steamership in the rough waters of the North Atlantic was no easy feat either, and in fact, the first two attempts failed when the cable snapped and sunk on the journey, wasting investor money, dashing hopes, and causing widespread public mockery of the project. Some of the criticisms were philosophical and eerily relevant today. Would instant access to information really make us any happier or better off? Nevertheless, in August 1858, after over a year of disappointments, the two massive cable-laying ships successfully reached their destinations in Newfoundland and Ireland, completing the connection that Field and others had prophesied. Once the line had been tested, an official message of goodwill was exchanged between Queen Victoria and U.S. President James Buchanan. Public celebrations erupted in cities throughout the U.S. and Europe, marking the dawn of a new era of unification between the old world and the new. It's hard to overstate how influential the so-called electric union was to the rapidly globalizing world of the 19th century. It meant that everything from stock and commodity prices to a declaration of war or peace could now be shared immediately. It's no surprise that Field's accomplishment was widely heralded at the time as the greatest human achievement in history, and Field himself became an international hero. Although the first cable only functioned for a few months before going dead, it proved that a link was indeed possible. Within a decade, more reliable and sophisticated undersea cables were laid by Field and many others. Throughout the 20th century, cable networks expanded and technology continued to evolve as telephones eventually replaced telegraphs and then digital data eventually replaced analog signals. While the original transatlantic cable could only transmit a few words per minute at best, today's fiber optic cables deliver hundreds of terabytes of data in just seconds. And there are a lot of them, stretching close to 750,000 miles in total, and more cable was laid in 2018 than in any year in almost two decades. Instead of brave entrepreneurs, now most new cables are being laid by the tech giants such as Amazon, Facebook, Google, and Microsoft, which collectively own or lease more than half of the undersea bandwidth. And although it seems that we live in a mostly wireless world, undersea cables still carry 99% of data traffic that crosses the oceans. So the next time you chat with someone on the other side of the world, keep in mind that it all started over 150 years ago by a visionary entrepreneur and his team pulling off what was once called the greatest work that the genius of man ever contemplated.